With everything that went down in Captain America, Civil War, it's easy to forget what happened in the first 15 minutes of the film. Let's be honest, when Spider-Man showed up, we completely forgot that Crossbones was even in this movie. However, his presence raises a big question that remains unanswered. Recap: the opening of Civil War follows Captain America along with his new team that is comprised of Black Widow, Scarlet Witch, and Falcon. The team was following intel that told them that Crossbones, who was a former Hydra agent, is planning a heist in Lagos, Nigeria. However, he makes a surprise hit on the Institute for Infectious Diseases, hoping to steal a biological weapon. The team manages to stop this plot, but the movie never answers the question as to who wanted a doomsday biological weapon or who even hired Crossbones in the first place. And this wasn't a random heist so that Crossbones could lure Captain America out into the open and kill him. He makes verbal confirmation that the virus they steal is the one they came for. Also, apparently, the virus they stole was so deadly and powerful that if the henchmen were to drop it, it would cause the death of a lot of people. So, who would hire Crossbones to retrieve such a deadly virus? Was he hired by Zemo? While probably everyone's first choice, it's most likely not the case, not only because we see him kill the ex-Hydra soldier in his home, but also due to the fact he only has one goal throughout the whole movie: Mission Report, December 16, 1991. Also, we could maybe stretch our disbelief a bit with Zemo's crazy convoluted plan to destroy the Avengers from the inside, but it's a little hard to believe that Lagos was part of that plan on top of everything else. Was he working out his ultimate plan and thinking, yes, I'll hire Brock Rumlow to steal a doomsday biological weapon, who will obviously be defeated in combat, and bring up Captain America's best friend Bucky, only for him to pop a grenade to kill both of them? But Scarlet Witch, who has only been on the team for a couple of months, will stop him and cause an explosion that will kill dozens of people and spark an international crisis. Seems a little overly complicated, even for Zemo's already confusing plan. Was he hired by Hydra? Probably more believable since Brock Rumlow was a sleeper agent for Hydra during the fall of SHIELD. However, Hydra also took a hit when SHIELD crumbled in Captain America, Winter Soldier, after the death of one of their leaders, Alexander Pierce. So, the question is, if Crossbones was hired by Hydra, why do they need a doomsday biological weapon, and who is now standing as the leader? Maybe Ant-Man can fill in a few of the gaps. In the film, it was revealed that Hydra was still in motion and associates of Hydra wanted to purchase the Pym particle formula and Yellow Jacket suit for unknown, nefarious purposes. While they weren't able to get their hands on the suit, Mitchell Carson, another Hydra sleeper agent, was able to grab the new formula that Darren Cross perfected. Could these two events be connected in some way? That's a hard one to determine due to the little plot details that have been released to the public about Ant-Man's sequel, hashtag Ant-Man and the Wasp. However, one thing we do know is that one of the villains will be Sonny Birch, a supplier for the government and a former chairman of Cross Industries. Maybe after the fall of Cross Industries, he had some nefarious plan for the biological weapon to start a new company. Maybe the failure of Crossbones is what leads him to make a partnership with the Ghost, a scientist who infused their body with ghost tech so that they could have a stronger connection with computer systems. Or maybe Crossbones was just acting out on his own. While there is more evidence to prove that Crossbones was hired by a higher power, there are few clues to suggest that he was just doing what was necessary to lure Captain America out into the open. For one, Crossbones has a real vendetta against Cap for what happened during the events of Captain America, Winter Soldier, after he was left stuck in a falling building that scarred his face. Not only does he now wear a face mask to hide his deformity, he personally blamed Captain America for what happened to him. During his first encounter with Cap, Crossbones yells out to him that he's been waiting for his chance at revenge. Even before landing a final blow on the superhero, he whispers in his ear, "This is for dropping a building on my face." Talk about not being able to drop a grudge. So it's very possible that the heist was simply a way to lure hashtag Captain America out into the open so that he could finish him off and finally get his revenge. We can't forget that Crossbones had basically lost the will to live, seeing how he would go as far as blowing himself up to kill his enemy. Who knows who orchestrated the biological weapon heist in the opening of Civil War? Maybe we'll uncover more clues about the new mastermind behind Hydra in a future film or TV series. We'll most likely learn more about Hydra's plans and actions in Ant-Man and the Wasp, so we'll have to wait and see what plot points Marvel reveals in the future.